Good afternoon, and welcome to Piping Up, presented by the Tabernacle Choir at Temple Square. I'm your host, Luke Howard. These organ concerts are streamed live every Wednesday at noon Mountain Time. Previous episodes of Piping Up are also available for on-demand viewing on the Tabernacle Choir's Facebook page and YouTube channel. And you can find out more information about this concert series at tabchoir.org/pipingup. Andrew Unsworth is our recitalist today, and the concert opens with his own arrangement of the African-American spiritual Little David, Play on Your Harp. This is a jaunty, joyful spiritual that was first popularized by the great Harry Burley, who published his arrangement in 1917. Burley published hundreds of songs and arrangements, many of them spirituals, and in addition to being a highly respected concert composer and singer, Burley was a mentor and coach to other black singers, including Paul Robeson and Marian Anderson. And he was a founding member of ASCAP, the American Society of Composers, Authors, and Publishers. So we have Harry Burley to thank for popularizing the following melody, for concert arrangements of spirituals in general, and for helping make sure the right people get credit for their performances. Louis Vierne was one of the most influential composer-organists in France in the early 20th century. While training the next generation of organists, he wrote 6 organ symphonies, taking full advantage of the new symphonic possibilities of Cavaillé-Coll's organ designs. Vierne composed his Organ Symphony No. 1 in 1899, while serving as an assistant to Charles-Marie Vidor at Saint-Sulpice. This symphony's second movement is a fugue, the only fugue Vierne ever composed. And while he believed it was well written, employing all the contrapuntal devices of a typical Baroque fugue, he later claimed it might have been a bit heavy-handed. But that's how he wrote it, and it's brilliant. Andrew Unsworth succeeded John Longhurst as a Tabernacle organist after John retired in 2007. So this next work, Longhurst's Cantilena, is Andrew's nod to his predecessor, part of a great chain that links together generations of Tabernacle organists going back well over 150 years. In that time, there have been less than two dozen officially appointed Tabernacle organists and associate organists. It's a very select group. And most, if not all of them, played the traditional pioneer hymn, Come, Come Ye Saints, on the Tabernacle organ as well. We'll hear first John Longhurst's Cantilena, and then Andrew Unsworth's arrangement of Come, Come Ye Saints.
Thank you.
exceptionally popular evangelical crusades of Billy Sunday and Homer Rodehiever in the late 19-teens and 20s often included rousing hymns and lively gospel songs. During many of these events, Rodehiever would sing duets with another member of the evangelist team, Virginia Healy Asher, who had a very fine contralto voice. Rodehiever and Asher sang and recorded together such beloved gospel standards as The Old Rugged Cross and In the Garden. The songs of Charles Hutchinson Gabriel were also popularized through these spirited evangelical gatherings. Gabriel was a prolific writer of gospel songs with, by some estimates, nearly 7,000 compositions to his name. And he eventually worked for Homer Rodehiever's publishing company. But years earlier, in 1898, Gabriel had written a hymn, Oh, It Is Wonderful, also known as I Stand All Amazed. In this hymn, the verses are sung as a tenor-alto duet, very much in the same style as Rodehiever's and Asher's gospel duets. I don't know if they ever actually sang I Stand All Amazed at one of their crusade events. Homer Rodehiever was a baritone, not a tenor. But I can imagine it in my mind's ear and picture the deeply stirring effect it would have had on the crowd, the same effect it has on so many listeners today, including me. The words to Gabriel's hymn, I Stand All Amazed, are, like many gospel songs of its time, quite personal and tender. Its evangelical fervor focuses on a powerful, individual, and intimate experience with the divine. The singer, contemplating Christ's grace and love, is confused, apprehensive, rebellious, and proud, but by the final verse is humbled and awed by the unfathomable reach of God's mercy. Oh, it is wonderful, the chorus exclaims, that he should care for me enough to die for me. Oh, it is wonderful, wonderful to me. Andrew Unsworth will play next his arrangement of Charles Gabriel's I Stand All Amazed, and he'll follow that with the Fantasia, Opus 121 by Sir Charles Villiers Stanford, a work also based on a hymn tune, in this case one written by Stanford himself for the Feast of All Saints. In fact, the Fantasia has subtitled In Festo Omnium Sanctorum, for the Feast of All Saints. The tune name is Engelberg, and Stanford wrote it to fit the words For All the Saints, but it's now paired much more frequently with the hymn, When in Our Music God is Glorified. First, I Stand All Amazed, then Stanford's Fantasia to conclude today's program. Thank you for watching today's episode of Piping Up, featuring organist Andrew Unsworth. We hope you enjoyed it. You are always welcome to come back for the weekly live stream of these concerts, and previous episodes are also available for on-demand viewing. Piping Up, Organ Concerts at Temple Square, streams every Wednesday at noon Mountain Time on the Tabernacle Choir's website, its Facebook page and YouTube channel, and at broadcasts.churchofjesuschrist.org.